Nahem Shoa is the curator of this exhibition called Face of Britain. He's also the artist responsible for many of the portraits, including his Giant Heads collection. 16 out of the 26 paintings are of black people.
I've emphasised black portraits because they have been neglected, and Britain has become a much more multicultural place and better for it. So this exhibition really is a celebration of outstanding portraiture.
Perhaps the most unusual portrait is this, the back of the head of Benga Lumoko, who Nahem has painted more than 20 times.
This painting represents, for me, all black men in a way who have been targeted by the police, have suffered lots of racism, and in this painting there's hope. It's all about looking into the future, looking into a better future with less racism and more opportunities, a much fairer Britain.
It's a message that is being heard by visitors.
I think it's good to see more black faces, especially by a more modern artist.
I think it's wonderful to have more representation for everybody in the country.
There's so much different information as you're getting into the details, and then stepping back you go, you know, the whole picture. It's pretty amazing.
The more black faces that you see, the more normal it becomes. History of art has made black imagery usually of slaves or servant that basically dehumanizes people. I try and see people as they are, as accurately as I can, because I want to stress individuality. How we confront racism is to see our humanity.
This exhibition will be seen by school children, which is a key part of its purpose.
It's very rare for young people to see these kind of images in art galleries. It would change the perception, open that discussion. That is what this is all about. Black History Month is a celebration. We're just trying to open up those little bits of history, those little nuggets that have been missed. And this is a nugget that has definitely been missed.
The exhibition is on at the city's art gallery until February next year. Richard Slee, ITV News, Southampton.